Ladies, she was our like biggest number one fan. Yes. She believed in us when she told us, go, like, you guys take this far. Like, don't be nervous. Don't worry about what people are going to say about you. Yeah. Just go and do God's work.
I think it's taking the step, because we all didn't, like, when we first started singing, we didn't think that, oh, we're gonna be like the frontliners. But it took like a step of us like starting to sing, and then someone hearing us sing and saying, oh, okay, you guys sound really good, you guys should be in the front. And then from there we got used to it. So I don't think it's something that we were used to in the beginning, but it's something that you get used to over time. So just take the initial steps. Maybe you don't have to be on stage singing. Maybe you could be helping, and then just getting used to looking at the crowd, and then from there start doing it. But you have to do it. If you don't do it, you're not gonna be able to move forward.
Yeah, I wanted to add, like, and just to trust God as well, because if He's calling you forth to do, you know, to lead in whatever capacity, it's because He has, obviously, you know, something for you to do, or there's a goal there. So just trust God and believe that He will keep you and show you, you know, what's next, how to do it, how He wants you to sound, how He wants you to look, because you never know who it is that you're going to be reaching with, you know, the capacity that you have at leading. So definitely lean, you know, not on your own understanding, but lean towards God so He can lead you in that way.
Start off in a choir. That helps.
Shout out to Sister Lee. She was our like biggest number one fan. Yes. She believed in us when she told us, go, like, you guys take this far. Like, don't be nervous. Don't worry about what people are going to say about you. Yeah. Just go and do God's work. You know, like, stay humble, but remember who it is that you're doing it for, and everything else will fall. You know, everything else will fall into order, but just trust God and believe in yourself. So thank you, Sister Louise.
She was, you know. Thank you.
Yeah, that's another thing.
That's not her mom.
Yeah.
That's my mom of the group.
I think that's a major thing too, like having someone to support you, and who understands and who sees that, man, you have this in you. You definitely should allow it to blossom. So
because she's a singer and a worship leader, she knows the hardships and the nervous parts of us. She knows everything.
Yeah,
she helped us so much.
Yeah, keep positive people around you.
Yes,
sure. Godly people.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So like a mentor, a coach, somebody
that will pray with you, give you scripture, encourage you when you're weak moments. Yeah. You know, just be there for you. Mm-hmm. And also to piggyback about letting others know to just not be afraid, is because I know personally, they all know, like, I was the last person in the group to leave. But the last person, and I think what motivated me was to know, just like in scripture, like how it says, if you don't cry out, the rocks will cry out.
Right.
And I would never want a rock to take my place.
Okay. Yeah.
I was created to do that, just that. Like, if I don't do it here, how am I gonna do it in heaven? And that's what I'm gonna do anymore. So that's one thing that motivates me.
Yeah, that hit me.
That's what motivates me, because I'm just like, man, like, I have potential. It's not like people don't tell me, and I know if they're telling me, they see something I don't see, and if they see it, God sees it, because most likely He would send them to me to tell me that and to encourage me. So it's just taking that first step, trusting in God, knowing that if He's putting you here, it's not for you to fail. His plans are always to prosper you anyway. So it's just trusting, having people around you that will help you through those situations, because we still all need each other, and just, you know, doing it. You gotta do it.